Alright, so let's talk about battery cycles, as there seems to be some confusion over my last video.
Not all computers and batteries are equal. First, let me show you the official cycle life of different batteries right from Apple. The iBook G3 and G4 systems had a cycle life of around 300. The PowerBook systems also had a cycle life of around 300. The original MacBook series had a cycle life of around 300. The MacBook Pro from the same era also had around 300. Once you hit the 2009 MacBooks, things start to change and you get 1,000 cycles. The same with the newer MacBook Pros and the newer MacBook Airs. Now, let me put things into perspective. Let's also discuss what a cycle is. A full cycle is when you discharge the battery all of the way down and then all of the way back up. But what if, for example, you discharge the battery halfway and then charge it back up? This is only half of a cycle. So you have to do this twice before it would equal a full cycle.
Okay, so let's put that in perspective. Just because Apple throws out a number like 300 cycles doesn't mean that the battery won't work past 300. It just means that after 300 cycles, the capacity will begin to degrade. So at maybe 400 cycles, the battery may only last 2 hours instead of 4 hours. And you know, when you get to 500 cycles, it may only last an hour. And when you get to 600 or 700 cycles, it may only last half an hour, or it may not work at all.
Let's talk about what factors besides cycles affect battery life. Temperature is a big one. Leaving it in hot environments, especially while in use, will degrade the battery much faster. Once you get around 120 degrees, like the inside of a hot car or something like that, you can pretty much kiss your battery goodbye if it spends much time there. Charging state matters.
So, for example, if you were to let the battery completely discharge, and then sit it on a shelf for a year like that, well, you can pretty much kiss your battery goodbye because it's going to be dead.
If you're going to store the battery, then take it out of the laptop so it won't discharge as quickly and try to charge it up periodically. If the battery is internal and the computer is going to be stored for a while, then just periodically make sure to charge the thing up. Depth of cycles. It's usually much easier on the battery if you only cycle the battery a little bit and then charge it back up, rather than always cycling it completely. And another thing is age. As the battery gets older, it will always degrade some, even if you haven't used it.
Okay, so we've covered the life cycle of a battery. Now let's talk about calibration.
If you open up a battery, you'll find a tiny computer or microcontroller inside of it. This controller is what keeps track of how many cycles the battery has gone through, as well as other information about the battery. Two of the things that this controller attempts to track is how much capacity is left in the battery and what is the current state of charge.
And just so that we're clear on this, the capacity is the amount of power that the battery can actually store under its present condition, which, as we've discussed, that shrinks over time as the battery degrades. The state of charge is different. That's a percentage of how full the battery actually is. Let me give you this example.
Imagine comparing it to a tank of liquid. The capacity would be the size of the tank. The state of charge is like how full the tank is. But it doesn't always get it right. The controller really doesn't know exactly how much power the battery can store. The only things it can really monitor is the voltage and the current as power is taken from or put back into the battery. It uses the history to track what it believes is the state of charge and the capacity. And this is how it's possible for a battery to become miscalibrated. Essentially, what this will cause is the battery gauge up here on the screen will not be an accurate reflection of the real battery. Keep in mind, this information is just an estimate.
Okay, so how can you be sure your battery is properly calibrated? Well, here's the best way to do it.
First of all, charge the battery all the way up overnight. Then, go into the system preferences under power and edit the parameters so that the computer will never shut the screen off or go to sleep. Now, set a timer and unplug the computer. Make a note of how long the computer thinks the battery will last. Be sure to keep an eye on the computer. Ignore any warning messages you get about being low on power. Wait for it to completely shut off. Then, make a note of the time of how long the battery was able to run. Then you can compare it to what the computer had estimated. Then charge the battery all the way back up immediately, and your battery should now be calibrated and the estimate should be more accurate.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. I got one bonus little link that I want to put up on the screen here for you. This takes you to an official Apple document that lists all of the cycle lives for the different computers that they've had over the last 10 or 15 years. So if you're not sure what the cycle life is on yours, go to this website and you can find out exactly. Otherwise, tell me what you'd like to see in the next video. And if you want to take part in a future video, send me an email and we'll see what we can do.